In the next few videos, we're going to go over the psychoanalytic theory of personality. Now, the first thing I want to mention is a theory is just a theory. It's not a fact, right? A theory is a set of explanations that one makes to explain the observations that they've made. So if we're thinking about the psychoanalytic theory, we have to start with Sigmund Freud. Freud was a physician who treated mental disorders using a technique he developed called psychoanalysis. The goal of psychoanalysis was to study the unconscious mind. To Freud, the unconscious mind was very important in determining an individual's motivations and behaviors. The way psychoanalysis works is the physician has very lengthy verbal interactions with the patient, and the goal is to determine the influence of repressed conflicts, sexual urges, early childhood memories, and internal conflicts on the motivations and behaviors of the individual. So when Freud had these long verbal interactions with patients, he made many observations and he developed the psychoanalytic theory to explain all of the observations that he made. Now, as I mentioned earlier, Freud really focused on the unconscious mind and how important it was for determining our behaviors. As an example, Freud believed that slips of the tongue, or Freudian slips, often reveal a person's unconscious desires. As an example, let's say you have an employee at a company and they're training a new hire. During the training, they meant to say, "Don't touch the hot wire," but instead they accidentally say, "Don't touch the hot hire." Now, hot hire certainly has a sexual aspect to it. To Freud, Freud would 100% take this as the employee training the new hire has sexual desires for that new hire. Right, so this is an introduction to psychoanalytic theory according to Freud. Again, this is just the theory, and we know now that most of what Freud came up with, there's very little experimental support for. So the next thing I want to go over is some criticisms of this theory. First, Freud believed that our behavior is primarily determined by unconscious thoughts that we're not aware of. A lot of psychologists had an issue with this because this suggests that we don't have conscious control over ourselves. It's this unconscious thoughts that we don't even know about that is controlling our lives. Second, Freud heavily emphasized the role of childhood experiences on our lives. And this suggests that our future is determined by the early years of our life. If this event happened in your childhood, you were going to grow up to be like this kind of person. And a lot of psychologists didn't like this idea that your future is determined solely by what happened when you were a child. And finally, Freud focused too much on sexual desires. So there are actually psychologists that came after Freud who built upon his theory and in some cases shifted the theory from sexual desires more so to social interactions. All right, so this is our introduction to psychoanalytic theory. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and clicking the bell icon for notifications. We release new videos every week covering the highest yield content on the MCAT. Plus, you can check out the video description for links to useful resources like our MCAT Prep mobile application.